everyone. Now today we are going to start a new topic of the chapter 4, that is relation. As we have learned, there are three different ways for transferring of heat from hotter object to colder object or from hotter end to colder end. And these ways are conduction, convection and radiation. Conduction and convection method already we have discussed in the last video. Now we will discuss about radiation method. So, when we go outside, have you ever thought when we go outside, we feel hot because we get heat energy from the sun? So, have you ever thought how this heat energy, it is reaching to the us from the sun? Because by the conduction method, heat can transfer only in solids. And so, it is not possible by the conduction method, heat can transfer from the sun to the us. And by the convection method, it is also not possible because by the convection method, heat can transfer only in liquids and gases. And because between the most part of the space, between the earth and the sun, there is in most part of the space, there is no air, no medium. And so for the conduction and convection method, in the convection and conduction method, medium is required. By the conduction method, heat can transfer only in solids, and by the convection method, heat can transfer all in liquids and gases. So for transferring of heat from sun to the earth, there is another method which is known as radiation. By the radiation method, heat can easily transfer from sun to the earth. So next is radiation. Radiation means the mode of transfer of heat from distant sources in the environment without requiring any medium or contact is called radiation. Because we are not in the direct contact of the sun, and sun is a very distant source, but we are getting heat energy from the sun. So there is another method for transferring of heat from distant sources in the environment without requiring any medium. In the radiation method, no medium is required, no solid, no liquid and no gas. Without any medium or contact, direct contact, heat can easily transfer from sun to us. This method is known as radiation. When we sit around a fire during a winter season, we feel hot because we get heat energy from the source of heat. And this heat energy, it reaches to the us from the source of heat because by the radiation method. Similarly, a hot utensils when we kept away from the flame, it after some time it becomes cool because it releases heat in the surrounding. And similarly, our body also, it releases heat in the surrounding and it also absorbs heat from the surrounding. So when we can say all hot bodies, all the source of heat, they radiate heat or they release heat in the surrounding. When this heat energy, this heat falls on any object, some part of this heat energy, it is reflected. Some part of this heat energy, it is transmitted. And some part of this heat energy, it is absorbed by the object on which it is falls. And due to the this heat energy, the temperature of the object, it is increases. Because this object, it absorbs some amount of heat from the source of heat. So, we can say the amount of heat absorbed by an object depends upon some factors. These are, so different objects, they absorb different amount of heat. So, the amount of heat absorbed by an object depends upon some factors. These are, the first is the nature of the material. Which material, different materials, they absorb different amount of heat, like metals or water. They absorb more amount of heat as compared to non-metals like copper, aluminium, iron. All are metals, so they absorb more amount of heat as compared to non-metals. Second factor is its distance from the source of heat. When an object, it is very near to the source of heat, it absorbs maximum amount of heat. But an object, it is very far away from the source of heat, it absorbs very less amount of heat. So, the amount of heat absorbed, it is also depends upon the distance from the source of heat. The third factor is color of the object. Generally, the dark colors absorb more amount of heat, but the light colors absorb very less amount of heat. Dark color, they absorb maximum amount of heat and they release very less amount of heat. and as well as light color, they absorb very less amount of heat, but they release very high amount of heat. Now our next topic is choice of colors in our light. As we are saying, dark colors, they absorb maximum amount of heat, but the light colors, they absorb very less amount of heat, and dark colors, they absorb maximum amount of heat, but they release very less amount of heat, and light colors, they absorb very less amount of heat, but they release very high amount of heat. For proving this, there is a one activity. In this activity, we take two tin can. One tin can, it is painted white from the outside, and another tin can, it is painted black from the outside. We pour equal amount of water in both the tin cans and leave both the tin cans in the sun for some time. After some time, we will observe that we can find the difference in the temperature of both the water, because the water which is filled in this tin can, which is painted black, the temperature of this water, it is high. So we can say the dark colors, they absorb maximum amount of heat, but the water which is filled in this tin can, which is painted white, the temperature of this water, it is very low. So we can say light colors, they absorb very less amount of heat. So dark color, they absorb maximum amount of heat, but light color, they absorb very less amount of heat. That's why the dark colors, they are very important in our life, as well as light colors also, they are very important in our life. Because dark color clothes generally we prefer during a winter season, because they absorb maximum amounts of heat, and we prefer light color clothes during a summer season, because they absorb very less amount of heat, and we can feel comfortable in winter season by wearing the dark color clothes, and we can feel also comfortable by wearing a light color clothes during a summer season, because light color clothes, they absorb very less amount of heat. Similarly, the solar cookers and the pipes of solar heaters, they painted black because they can absorb very maximum amount of heat. And the bottom of the cooking utensils, you can see they are painted dark color, they are painted black, so they can absorb maximum amount of heat from the source of heat from the flame. That's why the colors, they are very important in our life, dark colors as well as light colors. Now our next topic is woolen clothes keep us warm in winter season. As we know, when we wear woolen clothes during a winter season, we feel very hot, because wool is a poor conductor or insulator of heat. It means the heat can't easily transfer in wool. Wool is a poor conductor, or as well as it is an insulator of heat, because air is trapped in the wool fiber. Air can be trapped between the wool fibers, and this air prevents the flow of heat from our body in the surrounding. And this air which is prevented between the wool fiber, this air prevents the flow of heat from our body in the outer medium, because air is also poor conductor of heat, and wool, it is also poor conductor of heat. That's why when we wear woolen clothes during a winter season, we feel warm. Similarly, when we should prefer two thin blankets instead of one thick blanket, because between the two thin blankets, air can be trapped, air will be trapped, and this trapped air, it prevents the flow of heat from our body in the surrounding. That's why we should prefer two thin blanket instead of one thick blanket in the winter season, and we can feel warm. Thank you for watching my video. If you understand by my video, please like, share and subscribe my channel.